reason. I like it because for me, I see it as an indictment. Indictment in the sense that for 50 years, we have been so-called independent, but we have still not learned how to make use of our resources for our development. That is the indictment. It's like you have petrol, you know you have petrol, but because you say you have no capacity, you turn yourself into a beggar to do what you could have done without being a beggar. This agreement has many technicalities. Some of them have already been raised. But I'm not going to take long. I asked some few questions. I tried to understand when the Honorable Member for Upper Fraser West was intervening. She at least succeeded in clarifying some of the things that I didn't understand. But my question, first question is it that they have identified special places in our ocean where only the tuna and hake live to the exclusion of other species? If that is not true, is it that they have special fishing gears that they use and can catch only the tuna and hake, even where there are other species? I want that to be made clear to me, because if that is not true, and they don't have such special instruments, it means when they catch, they are likely to catch other species other than the tuna and the hake. And what do they do with that? Because those are not part of our agreement. I want that also to be made clear. And the other question is, what is the area, the dimension of the area in which this fishing is going to be practiced by the 41 vessels? What is the area, what is the area of the ocean? Are all these vessels going to be practicing at the same time or what? For me, technically, yes, you are talking about these species being migratory. And that is why they have agreements with all those countries you have mentioned. Because they are not in all these countries at the same time. There are specific times they are in one place and they go for them there. And when there is, they are finished, that they go, they move to another place. I think these people have special places where they go from one place to the other. And that's why they need to have as many agreements as possible, because these people are, these species are moving from one country to the other. But once they are in Gambia, they are Gambian fish. So there is no complaint about that. That's why we are having this agreement. Once they are in our waters, they are our fish. When they move out of our waters into another water, they are no longer our fish. So I don't have any problem with that. And I pray that they always come here. So that we'll have as much money as well. But you see, the interesting thing is, I think the member from Woodley raised a very interesting point. You commit a crime, and you also determine the penalty for your crime. That's why I say it's an indictment. You don't even have the capacity to know that a crime is committed against you, and you have no capacity to determine the punishment for that crime. The person committing the crime does it deliberately and also determines the penalty for the crime. 50 euros for a ton of tuna? Hey, that's charity. I think, I don't know how they have come to that. But these are very serious matters to be considered in the agreement. Because we are here to defend the interests of our country. I know European Union has been after the Gambia for this agreement for more than 20 years. Since the first Republic, madam, they have been seeking to have this agreement with the Gambia. Since the First Republic. I don't know how. They never succeeded with the First Republic, but they are now succeeding with us. I think we have to look at this very critically. The fact that we don't eat tuna or hake does not matter. We don't eat petrol, we don't eat diamonds. We don't eat all those things. But we don't say we don't eat diamond or we don't eat petrol, so therefore, no. These are our resources. We must develop, since we know that these are our resources, we must develop the capacity to tap them for the use of our country. If we don't eat it, but we export it. Like petrol, we export it. We have money. So where we beg, we stop being beggars. Where we take loans, we stop taking loans because we have the means to do what the loans will do for us. So, Madam Speaker, I think there are critical issues to be addressed in this agreement.